Okay, so in the previous part, we have solved or we have considered some variety regarding the problems which are of approximate estimate. Okay, now today we are going to take a new case for the problems for the approximate estimate, and this will be the last one. I think CBRI method, there is one method in the approximate estimate. I'm not going to ask. Till date, haven't asked for a single time. So we are just completing this particular part of the problem, and then we will proceed toward the rest part of the theory. And again, our important part is your Bar-Bedell shoulder. So you can note down the problem. Prepare a preliminary estimate. I hope everybody is having the notebook in their hands and a pen. So you can take a note of it. Prepare a preliminary estimate for a frame 4-storied building having carpet area 300 square meter. For each floor, assume areas occupied by corridor, veranda, lavatories as 25% of built-up area. And area that occupied by the walls and column is 8.5% of the same, that is of the built up area. Okay. So this is the problem which has been given, and for that particular problem, some data has been given. And with that, by using that data, we have to prepare the, we have to find out the approximate estimate for that particular storied building. So what data is being given to us? First is built up area rate. It is given for the ground floor excluding foundation. It is 1500 rupees per square meter. Built up area rate for first and second floor is 1650 rupees per square meter. Built up area for third floor is ₹1800 per square meter. Then extra for foundation is 20% of superstructure cost, that is rate required for the foundation is 20% of the superstructure cost. Then extra for special architectural treatment, that is architecture's cost, 1% of the building cost. For water supply and sanitary, 7% of the building cost. For electrical installations, 8% of the building cost. Then contingencies, 4% of the overall cost. And work charge establishment is 10% of overall cost. Other sources, 5% of the building cost. Now this is the given data for this particular problem. Okay. This will be the given data for this particular problem. Now let's begin the things one by one. What they have mentioned, the built up area is been given. So your built up area, that is nothing but your plinth area, is been mentioned. Okay, it may be built up area, it may be plinth area, whatever it may be, we have to follow the same procedure. Okay, so what does it includes? What does the plinth area includes? The plinth area includes your carpet area plus circulation area plus area occupied by the walls and columns. Correct? Please remember this thing again, this will help you. Your plinth area will include definitely the carpet area, it will include the circulation area, it will include the area occupied by the walls and columns. Correct? That is nothing but the plinth area or the built up area. Yes, Z. It is correct. Okay. So in this particular problem, the carpet area they have mentioned, if you see the problem, carpet area is given as 300 square meter. Okay. Just 10 minutes are left. Carpet area is given as 300 square meter. Then apart from that, nothing is given. Apart from that, nothing is given. Correct? So what are the other data has been given? That is, assume the areas occupied by the corridors, verandas. It is 25% of built up area, that is your plinth area, and area occupied by the walls and columns is 8.5% of the same. Okay, that is of the plinth area. Okay, plinth area cha around 8.5%. मी काल जसं सांगितलं लोड बेरिंग स्ट्रक्चर असेल तर 15 ते 17 कालच्या प्रॉब्लेम मधली मिस्टेक समजली का? आता हा प्रॉब्लेम वाचल्यानंतर लक्षात आला असेल. ठीक आहे, कालचा जो युनिव्हर्सिटीचा प्रॉब्लेम आला होता त्यांच्याकडून चुकून कार्पेट एरियाच्या 12% आणि कार्पेट एरियाच्याच त्यांनी डेटा झूम केलता. ठीक आहे, दॅट इज जस्ट अ मिस्टेक विच वॉज हॅपन्ड, बट प्लीज बी अलर्ट इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर केस. सो प्लिंथ एरियामध्ये आपण कार्पेट एरिया कन्सिडर करतोय, आपण सर्क्युलेशन एरिया असतो हॉरिझॉन्टल वर्टिकल आणि एरिया ऑक्युपाइड बाय वॉल्स अँड कॉलम्स. जर मी चुकीचं असेल तर लेट मी करेक्ट इफ आय एम रॉंग. ठीक आहे, सो काय दिलेले प्रॉब्लेम मध्ये, कार्पेट एरिया इज गिवन एज 300 स्क्वेअर मीटर, देन सर्क्युलेशन एरिया अँड एरिया ऑक्युपाइड बाय द वॉल द परसेंटेज इज गिवन टू अस, दॅट इज 25% अँड 8.5%, बट दॅट इज इन रिलेवन्स विथ द प्लिंथ एरिया, दॅट इज बाय इन रिलेवन्स विथ द प्लिंथ एरिया. ठीक आहे, प्लिंथ एरियाच्या रिलेवन्स मध्ये दिलेला आहे तो, परंतु प्लिंथ एरिया दिलेला नाही आहे. ठीक आहे, मग मला आधी काय करावं लागणार आहे टू सॉल्व सच प्रॉब्लेम्स? व्हॉट आय एम गोइंग टू डू, ऍट फर्स्ट आय हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट द प्लिंथ एरिया. मला आधी प्लिंथ एरिया फाइंड आउट करावा लागेल. हाउ आय एम गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द प्लिंथ एरिया? प्लिंथ एरिया इक्वल्स टू द कार्पेट एरिया प्लस सर्क्युलेशन एरिया प्लस एरिया ऑक्युपाइड बाय द वॉल्स अँड कॉलम्स. कार्पेट एरिया इज नोन टू मी, दॅट इज 300 स्क्वेअर मीटर. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दॅट सर्क्युलेशन एरिया इज एट सर्क्युलेशन एरिया इज हाउ मच इट इज गिवन, हा 25% ऑफ द प्लिंथ एरिया, अँड एरिया ऑक्युपाइड बाय वॉल्स अँड कॉलम इज गिवन एज 8.5% ऑफ द प्लिंथ एरिया. सो आवर नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू अज्यूम द प्लिंथ एरिया एज एक्स स्क्वेअर मीटर. ओके, लेट एक्स विल बी, एक्स स्क्वेअर मीटर विल बी द प्लिंथ एरिया. ओके, सो इफ आय पुट द प्लिंथ एरिया एज एक्स स्क्वेअर मीटर, सो माय इक्वेशन और माय फॉर्म्युला बिकम्स एक्स इक्वल्स टू 300 प्लस 25% ऑफ एक्स प्लस 8.5% ऑफ एक्स, दॅट इज एक्स इक्वल्स टू 300, दॅट इज कार्पेट एरिया, प्लस 0.25 इंटू एक्स प्लस 0.085 इंटू एक्स, दॅट इज 8%चं मी डायरेक्ट पॉईंटमध्ये घेतलेलं आहे, डिवाइडेड बाय 100. सो इफ यू सॉल्व दिस पर्टिक्युलर इक्वेशन, एक्स मायनस 0.25 एक्स मायनस 0.085 एक्स इक्वल्स टू 300 स्क्वेअर मीटर, सो 0.665 एक्स इक्वल्स टू 300 स्क्वेअर मीटर, सो एक्स इक्वल्स टू 451.13 स्क्वेअर मीटर. सो दिस इज द सिंपल टेक्निक, ऑलरेडी यू हॅव गॉन थ्रू द इन युअर स्कूल डेज ऑल्सो, दिस इज द सिंपल टेक्निक दॅट यू हॅव टू अडॉप्ट इफ यू फाइंड सच प्रॉब्लेम इन युअर क्वेश्चन पेपर. If plinth area is not given, you can find out the plinth area using the formula plinth area equals to carpet area plus circulation area plus area occupied by the walls and columns. Assume the plinth area is x square meter and solve the equation, you will get the plinth area. Now in this particular problem, the plinth area comes as 451.13. See, this is the only one thing which is the new one for you. After that, what they have mentioned, ground floor rate is ₹1500, correct? So ground floor rate, that is plinth area rate is, our plinth area is 451.13 square meter, and the cost for that ground floor rate is ₹1500. So if you multiply it by 451.13, that is with the area multiplied by the rate, plinth area multiplied by plinth area rate, you will get the first estimate, approximate estimate, that is for the ground floor. It is comes as 676,695 rupees. Okay, please check the calculations if it is wrong at some point. Then for the first floor and second floor, as we are dealing with the first floor and second floor, that means two areas we have to consider. So we have multiplied it by 2, that is 2 multiplied by 451.13 at a cost of ₹1650, that is 1650 rupees per square meter. So again, if you take the multiplication of plinth area, that is 2 multiplied by 451.13 multiplied by 1650, that is plinth area rate, you will get the answer as 1488,729 rupees. And for the third floor, again area will be 451.13 square meter and cost is 1800, so multiply the area with cost, you will get the answer as 812,034 rupees. So the total cost of that superstructure, total four storied building, that comes as 29,77,458 rupees. Okay, so for this particular total cost, what they have mentioned, we require the extra for foundation at 20% of the superstructure. So 20% of 29,77,454, 450 rupees. So that comes as 5,95,491 rupees. Okay. Then if you go, ये कैसे चेक किया रे 20%, 20% ऑफ सुपरस्ट्रक्चर, सुपरस्ट्रक्चर को टाला रे, सुपरस्ट्रक्चर अबोव द प्लिंथ, करेक्ट है? इट डिपेंड्स वेयर वेयर योर प्लिंथ इज अबोव दैट ग्राउंड लेवल और प्लिंथ इज इक्वल दैट इज एट सेम लेवल विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द ग्राउंड लेवल, और इट मे हैपन दैट योर प्लिंथ लेवल इज बिलो दैट पर्टिकुलर ग्राउंड लेवल. दे आर थ्री केसेस, सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू हैव टू अज्यूम which will be your superstructure. Okay, it is happening. Hey, do you know this thing? Your plinth level, it may be above the ground level, it may be equal to the ground level, or it may be one can take that is by digging what I can say, digging or making some excavation of around 1 meter below, and again filling the our plinth material and then laying down the foundation. Okay, so one can do that. So extra cost for the foundation is 5,95,000. So total building cost is 35,72,949 rupees. Then for architectural treatment, 1% of building cost. So the rest problem is same. There is no difference. What change is there? That change I have conveyed to you. That is the built-up only carpet area is given. From the carpet area, we have determined the plinth area. Okay, by considering the summation of play carpet area plus circulation plus area of the wall circumference. This is standard digital. Based on this, you can determine the plinth area. Then from the plinth area, determine the cost for each separate floor and do the rest calculations. Now, is there any problem in this particular part? Yeah, part madhe kunala ka adjacent aslas vichara. Otherwise, note down this particular problem. As far as problems of approximate estimate is considered, this is the last variety. Anyone is having any problem? Sarana problem, samajh laya ka? Everyone getting the problem? Is there any doubt in this? Samajla nasel ta vichara. We are having less than 1 minute to conclude this session. So please rejoin the session using the same link. You can rejoin this lecture using the same link immediately. Within a minute. Anyone is having any problem? Someone? Problem samajh laya ka? Ho kyun nahi?